Okay, here you see the answers to everything except for number 61. So you can pause and check your answers. And then I'll show you 61, and then I'm going to work through the problems. So if you need any help, you can watch that part. For 61, I'm just referring back to the unit circle that we made during our notes. And you're filling in the blanks that they give you in the book. They don't have a blank for everything, so just filling in the ones you need to. Okay. So going back to number 7, 60 degrees. So we're converting that to radians. So we know that 180 degrees is equal to pi radians. 60 is 1/3 of 180, so we have 1/3 of pi. So that would be pi over 3. So just think about it in terms of fractions. Number 8 is 30 degrees. 30 degrees is 1/6 of 180 degrees. So we have 1/6 of pi, which would be pi over 6 radians. Number 9 is 90 degrees. 90 degrees is 1/2 of 180 degrees. So it would be 1/2 of pi, which we write as pi over 2. Number 10 is 120 degrees. So in terms of finding a fraction, what I would do is I would think about 60. So 60 degrees is 1/3 of 180 degrees. And 120 is twice that. So 120 is 2/3 of 180 degrees. So we have 2/3 of pi. So we call that 2 pi over 3. Number 11 is 150 degrees. So I would think about 30 degrees. So 1/5 of 180 degrees is 30 degrees. So then, if we multiply that, oops, sorry, not 1/5, getting ahead of myself, 1/6 of 180 degrees is 30 degrees. So if we multiply that by 5, we get 150. So 5/6 of 180 degrees is 150 degrees. So that means we have 5/6 of pi. So we can call that 5 pi over 6. Number 12, 270 degrees. So I would think about 90. So 270 degrees, whoops, let me go back. 90 degrees is half of 180. And then if you multiply that by 3, you get 270. So 270 degrees is 3/2 of 180. So that means we have 3/2 of pi. We call that 3 pi over 2. Number 13, negative 300 degrees. So I'm going to first think about 30 degrees. So 30 degrees is 1/6 of 180 degrees. Then we multiply that by 10. So 300 degrees would be 10/6 of 180 degrees. By the way, you could do this with 60 instead of 30. 10/6 reduces to 5/3. So if we were doing 300 degrees, it would be 5/3 pi. But we're doing negative 300 degrees, so it's negative 5/3 pi. So negative 5 pi over 3. 14, negative 315. So let's think about that's a multiple of 45. So 45 degrees is 1/4 of 180. And then if we multiply that by 7, we get 315. So that would be 7/4 of 180. So we have 7/4 of pi. And then that one is negative as well. So negative 7 pi over 4. Is 450 degrees. So you could think about 45 or you could think about 90. I'm going to think about 90. So 90 degrees is 1/2 of 180. And if you multiply that by 5, you get 450. So 450 degrees is 5/2 of 180. So that means we have 5/2 of pi. So I'm going to call that 5 pi over 2. 480 degrees. Let's see, I'm going to think about that in terms of 60. So 60 degrees is 1/3 of 180. And then 480 is 8 times that. So 480 degrees is 8/3 of 180. So that means we have 8/3 of pi. So I'm going to call that 8 pi over 3. 1800. So I'm going to think about that as 10 times 180. So that means I have 10 times pi. So that's 10 pi. And number 18, negative 3600 degrees. So we know that 360 degrees is 2 pi radians. So we're going to multiply that by 10 to get 3600. That would be 20 pi radians. And then it's going to be negative, so negative 20 pi. So that's the first section where we're converting to radians. And then for the next section, we're going to convert to degrees. So for 25, we have pi radians, pi thirds radians, pi over 3. So change pi to 180, and you have 180 degrees over 3. So that would be 60 degrees. So all we're going to do for this section is substitute 180 degrees in for pi. 26. 8 pi over 3. 8 times 180 over 3. 180 over 3 is 60, so 8 times 60, and that's 480, 480 degrees. 27, 7 pi over 4. So 7 times 180 over 4. 180 over 4 is 45. 7 times 45 is 315. You don't really even need a calculator for most of this. 28, 2 pi over 3. So maybe you remember that pi over 3 is 60. So this is 2 times 60. If not, you put the 180 in there and you work it out. So that's 120 degrees. 29, 11 pi over 6. So maybe you remember that pi over 6 is 30 degrees, and 11 times 30 is 330. If not, you put the 180 in there, you divide, and you get your 30, get the same answer. 30, we have 15 pi over 4. So maybe you remember that pi over 4 is 45 degrees. So we have 15 times 45 degrees. I'm going to grab my calculator for this one. 15 times 45, 675. Negative pi over 6. So hopefully you remember that pi over 6 is 30 degrees, so this is negative 30 degrees. If not, you just take 180 and you divide it by 6. 32, negative 8 pi over 5. So we didn't talk about pi over 5. I'm going to put the 180 in there. Negative 8 times 180 divided by 5. I'm going to start with 180 divided by 5, and that's 36. So this is negative 8 times 36. And that gives us negative 288 degrees. 33, 7 pi over 10. Okay, so pi over 10 would be 18, because that would be 180 over 10. So 7 times 18 is 126, so 126 degrees. 34, 11 pi over 15. So that would be 11 times 180 over 15. You can do the 180 over 15 first if that's easier. It might even be one you can do in your head. I don't know. 12. 11 times 12. And that gives us 132. 35. Negative 4 pi over 15. Well, we just saw that pi over 15 was 12. So this is negative 4 times 12. So it's negative 48 degrees. 36, negative 7 pi over 20. So you can figure out pi over 20 if you do 180 over 20. 180 over 20 is 9, so negative 7 times 9, and that's negative 63. 37, 11 pi over 20. Once again, pi over 20. Oops, should be 17 pi over 20, sorry. Once again, pi over 20 is going to be 180 over 20, which is 9, so 17 times 9, and 17 times 9 gives you 153, so 153 degrees. 38, 11 pi over 30. So you can figure out what pi over 30 is. 180 over 30 is 6, so we have 11 times 6, and that's 66. 39, negative 5 pi. So just put a 180 in for pi. 5 times 180 is 900, so this is negative 900 degrees. And 40, 15 pi. Same idea, just put 180 in for pi. And that's going to give you 2700 degrees. Okay, there we go.